हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज हेड इंजरी। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द टॉपिक आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू दैट इफ़ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो देन प्लीज़ लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब दिस वीडियो चैनल। नाउ वी स्टार्ट विद द डेफिनेशन ऑफ हेड इंजरी। हेड इंजरी इज जनरल टर्म यूज टू डिस्क्राइब द एनी ट्रॉमा टू द हेड एंड मोस्ट स्पेसिफिकली टू द ब्रेन। दिस मे और मे नॉट इंक्लूड द ब्रेन। Etiological factors includes common causes of head injury include penetrating trauma, blunt trauma, traffic accidents, falls, physical assault, accidents at home, work, outdoors or while playing sports, then violence and abuse. Then classification according to GCS, that is Glasgow Coma Scale, in that mild injury, for that loss of consciousness up to 15 minutes and GCS score is 13 to 15. Then moderate injury is there, then GCS score is 9 to 10, in that loss of consciousness for up to 6 hours occur. Then if a severe injury is there, then GCS score is 3 to 8, in that loss of consciousness greater than 6 hours in a patient. Now types of head injury includes a scalp injury, in that the scalp has many blood vessels, so any scalp injury may bleed profusely. Control bleeding with direct pressure, and other is the skull injury and skull fracture. Skull injury includes a fracture to cranium and the face. If severe enough, there can be injury to the brain. In that, linear skull fracture, depressed skull fracture, and basilar skull fracture is there. As you can see in a figure, scalp injury, skull fracture and brain injury is seen. Now, types of brain injury includes concussion, contusion, diffuse axonal injury and intracranial hemorrhage. In the first is the concussion is considered a mild brain injury and temporary loss of neurologic function with no apparent structural damage. If there is loss of consciousness, it is for 5 minutes or less, and a concussion is a type of traumatic brain injury by a bump, blow or jolt to the head or by a hit to the body that causes the head and brain to move rapidly back and forth. You can see a concussion in a patient. Now, contusion. A contusion is a bruise to the brain caused by a direct impact to the head. It may lead to hemorrhage also. Patient lose consciousness for considered amount of time. Then, diffuse axonal injury. It is characterized by extensive generalized damage to the brain. Then, axon are stretched and damaged. It is severe form of injury. Now, intracranial hemorrhage is defined as any bleeding within the skull. May or may not be seen with fracture. You can see epidural hematoma, okay, then intracerebral hematoma and subdural hematoma. Now types of intracranial hemorrhage. There are four types of intracranial hemorrhage includes epidural hemorrhage, subdural hemorrhage, subarachnoid hemorrhage and intracerebral hemorrhage. Now, signs and symptoms includes disturbance of consciousness, confusion to coma, increased intracranial pressure, then headache, vertigo and disorientation, then agitation and restlessness, increased blood pressure, nausea and vomiting, pupillary abnormalities, then changes in vital sign, that is tachycardia, tachypnea, then altered or absent cough reflex, then sensory impairment and paralysis in a person. Now diagnostic investigations includes history and physical examination, then CT scan and MRI, X-ray of a skull, then PET scan, blood test and cerebrospinal fluid analysis. Then complications of head injury includes coma, chronic headaches, loss of or change in sensation, hearing, vision, taste or smell, then paralysis, seizures, speech and language problems, and death may also occur. Now, medical management includes management of increased intracranial pressure, then antibiotic therapy, anti-epileptic therapy, and supportive measures includes ventilator support, vasodilator for blood pressure, then seizures prevention, fluid and electrolyte maintenance, then nutritional support and pain management. Then surgical management includes evacuation of blood clot, then debridement of penetration, then elevation of depressed skull fracture, and suturing of severe scalp laceration in a patient, then craniotomies. Now nursing management includes ineffective cerebral tissue perfusion related to increased intracranial pressure, then ineffective breathing pattern related to increased intracranial pressure or brain injury, then impaired airway clearance related to brain injury, fluid volume deficit related to decreased level of consciousness and hormonal dysfunction, then risk for injury related to decreased level of consciousness, then knowledge deficit regarding the treatment modalities and current situation. Then other are the ineffective thermoregulation related to damage to hypothalamic centers, then risk for impaired skin integrity related to compromised circulation, shifting of a fluid from intravascular to interstitial space, then anxiety related to outcome of disease as evidenced by poor concentration on work, then isolation from others, then rude behavior. So thank you friends. अगर इस टॉपिक के बारे में कोई भी कमेंट हो तो प्लीज़ कमेंट बॉक्स में जाके कमेंट करें और मेरे इस वीडियो चैनल को लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूलें.